Christmas. This is Mr. Sandy Claus. I'm reporting from the North Pole. I'm making this video because I've gotten a lot of letters recently asking my advice on what gifts people should buy this holiday season. The first letter I have here is from a woman named Jessica. She's writing from New Jersey. She says, "Hi, Santa. I know kids are usually the ones to write you this holiday season, but I'm in desperate need of a gift idea for my sister. Maybe you'll know. She loves to read, and I was going to get her an Amazon Kindle, but she already went out and bought one herself. However, there's something to be said for having a real book. And yes, I will have to agree with you on that one, Jessica. So, what do you suggest?" "I suggest a book from my personal library, Kurt Vonnegut's Slaughterhouse-Five. This book tells the story of Billy Pilgrim's life, starting when he was captured and imprisoned during World War II. All throughout the story, events that occur in Billy's life, present and past, are mixed in. Many of them are told as Billy time travels to the past and to the future. Through these flashbacks, we learn that Billy lives a normal life in New York, with his wife and two children. Through these flashbacks, we also learn that Billy was kidnapped by aliens. During his stay, he adapts to the aliens' philosophy of time and reality. After Billy returns to Earth, he starts talking to the people about his time travel and his abduction. He takes a trip to New York City and appears on a radio show to tell everyone what has happened to him. However, everyone thinks he has gone insane. One of the biggest themes in this book is fate. While he is with the aliens, he accepts their philosophies without question and begins to believe, like them, in the inevitability of what has happened, is happening, and will happen. Now I will read a passage from the book. If I hadn't spent so much time studying Earthlings, said the alien, I wouldn't have any idea what was meant by free will. I visited 31 inhabited planets in the universe, and I have studied reports on 100 more. Only on Earth is there any talk of free will. As Billy listens to the aliens, he learns that their views on the universe are completely different than those of humans. The aliens believe that everything is determined by fate and that there is no such thing as free will. I recommend this book mostly because I like the overall themes of fate, time distortion, and free will. Kurt Vonnegut does a great job at analyzing each of these themes and connecting it to the human race. This is a great read for anyone who likes science fiction. However, I must warn you, this is not an easy read. Anyway, I hope that answers your question, Jessica, and I hope your sister enjoys this book as much as I did. Well, that's all the time we have, folks. This is Santa signing off from the North Pole. Ho, ho, ho. Merry Christmas.